We design and develop platforms that can carry any payload, whether that's supplies, critical aid, and ultimately people, over any obstacle with minimal or no logistics and at the push of a button.
I am looking forward to the day where a TRV saves someone's life in a disaster, where they need emergency supplies, where they are in a location that cannot otherwise be serviced. And I think that's part of that kind of, that shared goal of not just supporting the military requirements, but building the capability that can be used and beneficial for a number of use cases. Our partnership started probably over a drink in a pub in the UK, talking about how we could bring the latest UAS technology to the warfighter.
When we started, we did not have any avenue, any way to reach US customers, for instance. And SURVICE were really keen on helping, and they provided all the staff, resources, and that avenue to talk to the customer, as well as additional technology, just to make the vehicle a capability for the US DoD.
I think Malloy, at the time, what was focused on commercial applications, disaster relief, but we were looking at the possibility of what were the use cases that our soldiers and Marines could use this kind of capability.
We've been able to leverage needs and requests from both sides of the Atlantic. So where we've been developing things for the US DoD, soon after we've seen a similar request from the UK DoD, and vice versa, has allowed both customers to actually get the best product for their needs. So I think it's worked really well.
I think it's been a success, right? Both for the US soldiers and Marines, but also for warfighters in the UK and now in Ukraine.
We design the aircraft, we build and manufacture it in-house in the UK, we test it, and then after we QC it, we ship it to the US. And here's where it gets modified to suit the US customer, and that's the part that SURVICE does. And having a part like SURVICE engineering that's really close to the customer gets us a very valuable feedback to then further develop the aircraft.
The US DoD and warfighters had a number of specific requirements from tactical communications, encryption, developing a ground control system that a warfighter could use after a day or two of training, testing in a variety of environments, from extremely cold to the hot desert. So all of these kinds of additional requirements are things that we have worked in partnership with Malloy to basically make the platform more robust for specific requirements that the military has.
Malloy Aeronautics is a British company. Why Waltham is a historical place. It's a really nice tiny airfield, green grass airfield with a flavor from World War II. We started our company in what could be considered a barn at the edge of the airfield, and now we've expanded. We started to expand into one of the hangars, then we expanded to the second one, and we've just recently taken the third one. So we triple our workspace in a matter of a year just to fulfill that demand that we got from the customers. So that's been really interesting and really good.
At the Applied Technology Operation, we've always had research and development in our DNA. We've worked a number of small business innovative research grants, and that really helped set the stage so that when this opportunity came up to work in the robotics and unmanned aircraft field, we were, even though we weren't really knee deep in that at the time, we had all the right personnel experience to help make that a success.
Everyone around us, until they get to know us, they think the same thing. They're a bit suspicious about what we do, but once we show people where aviation's going, and they're all aviators, they get really interested, and we start to get some real support from all the users that we have in there. So yeah, it's been a journey. It's been a really fun journey.